At the making of today's episode, boxing fans may be on the brink of witnessing the first undisputed world champion at 147 pounds since 2006 if the two undefeated welterweight rulers, Terence Bud Crawford and The Truth, Errol Spence Jr., meet up for the ultimate unification bout in the post-Floyd Mayweather Jr. and Manny Pacquiao era. Hey ringsiders, what is going on? This is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer, and welcome back to Ringside Stories. Feel free to subscribe, thumbs up, and hit that notification bell for your fresh content regarding boxing. It helps with the YouTube algorithm and grow the channel, so thanks so much for your support in advance. Today we'll talk about three potential future stars in the 147-pound division who might be in line for one of the world titles in the case Spence versus Crawford for whatever reason is not up next. Let's get into it. Virgil! Number 1, Vergil Ortiz Jr.
In your opponent's hometown, you've got to wonder how much the crowd's reaction is influencing the judges. Can Orozco get a fair shake? He just caught a big left uppercut and goes down!
Fan-friendly, has relentless pressure, power puncher.
Ortiz is a great finisher! Catches him with another left, a right hand across the jaw! He's letting his fist fly, and down for a second time! It's a roof!
18 wins, 0 losses, 18 wins by stoppage.
He gets up right before the count of 10. Still a long time to go. 1:30 here in round 6. Ortiz Jr. trying to pick up the defining win of his career.
Virgil's a warrior. You know, he, if anybody's disappointed about not fighting tonight, it's Vergil. And he's proven that time after time.
They know Vergil is a threat to them. They know. They could say whatever they want, but they know Vergil's not going to be easy for them. I think Vergil has the tools, the heart, the power to dominate.
Big right hand landed by Ortiz right there. Ortiz thought he went down. Orozco's still up. Totally gone. And this fight is over. The homecoming. A rousing success for Vergil Ortiz Jr. The man they call relentless was forced to relent tonight.
Notable wins, Egidius Gavalauskas, a.k.a. Mean Machine, who challenged Terence Crawford for the WBO welterweight world title once.
Power punch to erase Gavalauskas once and for all, and he's done it! The Texas Hammer drops again!
And former light welterweight world champion, Maurice Hooker.
Phenomenal! Vergil!
Crawford is possibly the number one pound-for-pound boxer in the world, you know, definitely top two. I'm looking at you, bud. I'm looking at you. If you want to make this fight, then I'm more than willing to do it. I don't care if I'm ready or not. I want that fight.
He really don't want me. That's just the thing that's due. It's called for the fighters that's at the top right now. But, you know, he's doing his thing. He's doing what he's supposed to do. And I wish him nothing but the best.
As offensively gifted as Vergil Ortiz Jr. is, he still needs to improve defensively before he can mix it up and be competitive with the current crop of champions. He's got time on his hands because even though Ortiz is a top 5 welterweight according to all 4 major sanctioning bodies at the making of this episode, Vergil Ortiz Jr. is just 24 years of age. Number 2, Jaron Ennis. Philadelphia's own Boots Ennis has it all. Showmanship, God-gifted athleticism, and ever-impressive improving boxing abilities.
If anything should be a non-fungible token, it should be that fight-finishing combination by Jaron Boots Ennis.
So far, Jaron Boots Ennis has won 26 out of his 29 fights by stoppage and is hungry for more.
This I love doing this. Like, I'm not in this for the money. I'm in this because it's all I know. Right. And I'm in here having fun and doing my thing. So when they know you fighting a guy like that, they're a shot away from me. So, right. I mean, at the end of the day, it is what it is. And they can't keep hiding for too long, and I will be world champion.
He switches to lefty, and he's actually more powerful than he is as a righty. At the end of the day,
Ennis is even better from the left-handed stance.
Notable wins include Tomas Delorme, who lost his first world title challenge at the hands of Terence Crawford, and who Jaron Ennis destroyed in a single round.
That right hook from Ennis, impressive as well.
Really impressive, and like you mentioned, I mean, to keep the power at a left-hand stance, and it was the hook that hurt him, and the uppercut that just, you know, finished the job.
And former IBF light welterweight title holder, Sergei Lipinets.
Less than a minute left in the first half of this 12-round affair. Jaron Ennis with the left-hand drops. Lipinets, no doubt about
that's
this
it, son.
One.
That's it.
And
that's
the fight
that's
has
it.
Been stopped.
Let's all calm down.
And Jaron boots that's Ennis. It, passes his biggest test in flying colors, recording his 25th KO. Ennis, the first man to stop Sergei Lipinets. Sergei Lipinets. Known as Samurai, but it's Jaron Boots Ennis, sharp as a katana tonight.
His reflexes, his defense, his punch output, his stamina. You don't even see the guy sit down in the corner, right? And he's young, he's hungry. They wouldn't give him an opportunity, and I understand why.
Yeah, I see a lot of similarities in him and myself, him and Sugar Leonard, him and Terence Crawford, you know a lot. Yeah, go both sides, just like Terence. I mean, it's a beautiful thing to see. You know? It's a matter of can you take a punch, and does he have a heart? Once you see them two things get proven,
stars born.
Stars born.
Absolutely.
I feel like he's definitely ready to show and prove that he's one of the best in the world.
As splendid as Jaron Ennis has looked thus far, Boots did get hit more than he should against less than stellar opposition. And unless Jaron Boots Ennis steps up in competition, we are left speculating the depth of talent we are dealing with.
You know, Errol Spence hit me flush, numerous times, flush. And I wasn't fazed by it. And see, I wasn't in for a second in my head where I went, oh, I could get knocked out. Not at all. Jaron Ennis, dangerous power.
At the making of this episode, Jaron Ennis is just 24 years of age. Number 3, Conor Benn.
A couple of years ago, they were laughing at him, going, I'll fight Conor Benn, oh, blimey. Now they're asking for 10 mil to fight Conor Benn.
More control and it'll all be over. Yes, that's it. It's all over.
As a son of a former British boxing legend, one may think Conor Benn has to deal with unfair expectations coming from both boxing fans as well as his own family. Similar to his dad Nigel, Conor Benn carries the nickname The Destroyer, which has led him to 21 wins, 0 losses, with 14 wins coming by way of stoppage. So far, Conor Benn has been well matched by promoter Eddie Hearn, bringing excitement, intensity to go along with newfound patience and boxing skills.
Happy to punch with him. Right hand left hook from Conor Benn. Punch. Another good left hook from Conor Benn. With a minute to go in the opening round.
Notable wins include South African veteran Chris van Heerden, who Conor Benn wiped out inside 2 rounds.
Only the second that Conor Benn has faced in his career.
And former WBO light welterweight title holder Chris Algieri.
Oh, good one. Two is down. Left-right combination, and it is all over in an instant. And Conor Benn has produced the performance of his career.
Benn is growing in confidence, facing decent level opposition, according to the level he is at right now.
But my point is, they're not tests. And every time I say they're not, you know, it sounds like arrogance, but it's just confidence speaking. You know, when I say I'm top five, I'm top five for a reason. No one ain't done that to Algeria. No one beat Granados as easy as I did. No one knocked out Vargas in 1 round. So it's like, well, what more do I have to do? What more do I have to do?
Conor Benn is a bit raw, however, is showing improvements in his latest fight. Currently, Benn is 25 years of age, and just like Jaron Ennis and Vergil Ortiz Jr., all of the major sanctioning bodies have the Destroyer currently ranked as a top 5 welterweight.
Champion put on a great performance there, and look, I'm sure he's going to go far in life. I mean, he's got a brilliant career, and we can only support him, man. That's what it's all about.
Listen, we know money always talks. That always talks.
I've made a lot of money in the game. I think it's about just enjoying this time off at the moment, and then once the hunger comes back again, let's see where we go from here. Yeah. But,
However, in order to see what Conor Benn is really made of, he's got to mix it with better fighters. Keep an eye out on these young and potential future welterweight stars, because we might witness the next welterweight great or greats soon. Let us know in the comments below what you think of Conor Benn, Vergil Ortiz Jr., and Jaron Boots Ennis. If you enjoyed this kind of content and you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe, give a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell. It helps out the channel a lot, i.e. inspire us to make more quality content for y'all. Now, if you've done that already, you're amazing. We already know that you are the true undisputed world champion. Till next time, ringsiders, this is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer, with Ringside Stories. Thanks for watching, and have a legendary day.